I stumbled upon you on a fluke. I want to say it was on YouTube, yeah. Either on YouTube or on Twitter. I can't remember which one. But you always got the good access before the fights, even after the fights. I appreciate that.
You just said Seckbach. I like your stuff.
Yeah,
but,
yeah, yeah.
But you know what's funny? Before you said Seckbach.
What's funny is that you cut over to ass and muscles.
Omar, I saw these two girls, and they were like talking to me, and they were like, take one home.
No, because Omar, Chad was saying how much of...
I gotta go. This is a high-pressure situation.
All right, Chad, on a serious note, Chad came up here before. He said Omar is one of the coolest dudes I've seen.
He's solid gold, man. And actually, he's going to help me work out, apparently, because he's big as a house and he's walking around with two grown women.
Why are you such a big, Omar, why are you such a big boxing fan?
I'm just a big sports fan, but boxing because, I mean, there's nothing like the sweet science. I've been trying to get into UFC, and I just can't seem to do it the same way. And hopefully, boxing will take a turn against the corruption because it's too far now, man. It's too many questionable decisions, too many fights. Don't get made that should get made.
Like, which ones do you want to see right now?
I don't know. Right now, actually, I have to say, I can't front. I'm impressed that Floyd's going to fight Canelo. I think he did it the right way because I think actually believed that Canelo could beat him, but I think Canelo needs a little bit more time before he's ready to beat him, so I think that Floyd worked his magic again in the sense that he got the kid at the right time. But you can't front on him, man. He's fighting the best out there. And, you know, I still would like to see him fight Manny Pacquiao, which, you know, is never going to happen. And there's too many fights that don't get made. And I also don't appreciate the fact that none of the American heavyweights are willing to get in shape. It's a nightmare, dude.
Chris Arreola?
None of them. I mean, guys walk around looking like me. I'm not a professional boxer. If I was a professional boxer, I would have to get in professional boxing shape.
Okay, Rios Pacquiao, November 23rd, yeah. In China. Brandon Rios trains in Oxnard.
Yeah.
Manny Pacquiao's going to train in the Philippines. Break it down, Omar.
I mean, I'm rolling with Pac-Man. You get knocked out like that, it's devastating. You never know how a guy's going to bounce back. But I have a lot of faith in that guy. And people seem to sell him up the river very, very quickly, like he was some kind of chump. And in real life, he was beating the hell out of Marquez before he got the knockout drops. And, I think it's very suspicious that you fight a guy for 36 rounds and you can't even knock him down. And all of a sudden, you put him lights out, man. You come in looking like a Greek god. I don't know. I want him to clean up the sport. This is where I'm down with Floyd. Everybody needs to do the USADA testing. It all needs to be above board, and that's that.
So last thing, Omar, we'll do a wager over here. If Rios beats Pacquiao, you got to wear a Seckbach shirt for a week. If Pacquiao beats...
For a week? Do I get to watch it?
Yeah, you get to watch it. I'll give you five of them.
Oh, okay.
If Manny wins, I'll wear anything you got to represent give you next.
You know what? That'll be perfect timing because my movie comes out right around Thanksgiving. All right, so
I'll
be
give you my card.
Timing. All right, I'll get you up.
Hit me up and we're going to...
Get your sack back.
I'm gonna get your sack back. I'm going to get Brandon Rios to comment on this tomorrow.
Ah, okay. Hey, good luck.
What's the Twitter?
At Omar Miller. It's me. It's just my name. And it's like having my phone number. Hit me.
There you have it. Omar Miller. Stay tuned. Be the point. Omar Miller. Back reporting.